Here, a particle, the projection of the particle and the diameter of the circular motion is a simple harmonic motion. Now, we have to discuss some characteristics of simple harmonic motion. Here, this Pn is the projection on this diameter y dash. Here, this is the diameter x dash I am taking. And from the diagram, here, this is the displacement of the particle. This is the displacement. This angle is theta. And this particle is moving with the angular velocity omega. And in the time t, from this point to this point it reached. And now we have to calculate the displacement. The displacement of a particle. Here, displacement means here this particle, that means the projection of this particle is making and always it is reaching from mean position to extreme position. Here the displacement is along a straight line from the mean position. Here the displacement we have to calculate by the right angle triangle OPN. From this OPN, right angle triangle, then we'll get, I'm calculating from that here the displacement is along y axis. That's why the distance here, the displacement along y axis I am taking y. Here from the right angle triangle POPN we are calculating sin theta is equal to, here we'll get ON by OP. From this ON is equal to OP into sin theta. That is ON is y, that y is equal to OP. OP value is I am taking A into sin theta. But from the circular diagram we can get this O, this theta is equal to, we can write omega into T. That is y is equal to, we can write A sin omega into T. This is the displacement of simple harmonic motion. Displacement of simple harmonic motion, y is equal to A sin omega t. Here this A is the radius and omega is the angular velocity and t is the time. This is equation 1 I am taking. Now velocity. Velocity means the rate of change of displacement is called velocity of the simple harmonic motion particle. Here velocity v is equal to, we can write t by dt into y. The rate of change of angle displacement is called velocity. Here d by dt into a sin omega t, that we can write a omega cos omega t. Here this is the velocity of a particle executing simple harmonic motion. Now again we have to calculate acceleration. Here acceleration a is equal to, we can write the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Now a is equal to d by dt into velocity a omega cos omega t. Now we can write this d by dt of a omega cos omega t means a omega into d by dt into cos omega t. Now we can write a omega square cos this sin omega t minus a omega square sin omega t. This also we can write a is equal to minus a omega square this sin omega t. the sine omega t, this A sine omega t we can write y, that is minus omega square y we can write. This is the acceleration of a simple harmonic motion. Here this v we can write A omega into this cos theta, we can write square root of 1 minus sine square omega t. Then we can write omega, A omega into square root of 1 minus sin square omega t. This sin square omega t we can write 1 minus y by a whole square, that is a omega under root a square minus y square by a square, that is we can write a omega under root a square minus y square by a, this a gets cancelled, omega under root a square minus y square. This is the velocity of particle executing simple harmonic motion. Now time period, time period means the time taken to complete one oscillation. The time taken to complete one complete oscillation is called time period, and the time period t is equal to 2 pi by omega. Here omega is the angular velocity and t is the time period. Now this we can write t is equal to 2 pi by omega. In this 2 pi by omega, this omega value we have to write. Here from this equation 3, this omega is equal to, we can write under root omega square is equal to a by y we can write. Then omega is equal to under root a by y, and substituting this under root a by y into this equation, we'll get time period t is equal to 2 pi under root y by a. This is the time period of particle executing simple harmonic motion. This we can write again, t is equal to 2 pi under root displacement by acceleration. Here y is the displacement and a is the acceleration. And next, phase of the particle executing simple harmonic motion. Here phase means the phase at any instant of time is defined as the state or condition of the particle. State or condition. Here state or condition of a particle means the position of the particle or the velocity of the particle. It decides the position of the particle or the velocity of the particle. This is called a phase of the particle. The phase of a particle is defined as phase of the particle at any instant of time is defined as the state or condition of the particle at that point. Here state or condition means position or velocity of the particle. Here this phase we can write theta is equal to, already we have theta is equal to omega into t, where this t is equal to time period, and omega is equal to, we can write by this omega is equal to, we can write 2 pi by capital T. This 2 pi by t into small t, that is 2 pi by t we can write. Here this theta is the phase angle. This theta is the phase angle. If for example this t is equal to, I am writing this t is equal to, if for example this theta is if this time t is equal to, if we write one complete time period, then we'll get theta is equal to 2 pi into capital T by T, that is T gets cancelled, we'll get theta is equal to 2 pi. That means after one complete time period, Again, the particle comes to the same position along the straight line. This is the phase of an angle. Here, the phase angle of a particle is defined as the state or condition of a particle. Here, theta is equal to 2 pi into t by capital T. Here, if t is equal to capital T, then theta is equal to, we'll get 2 pi. Here, the particle again comes to the same position after every one time period completing. Here, the phase difference. Here, if two particles executing simple harmonic motion, if they are traveling in the same direction, then the phase angle is 2 pi. And if the particles are, the one particle is at a mean position and another particle is at extreme position, then the phase angle between them is pi by 2. If one particle is at mean position and another particle is at extreme position, then the phase difference between them is pi by 2. And if the two particles are crossing the mean position at the same time but in the opposite direction, then the phase difference between them is pi. If the two particles executing simple harmonic motion, they cross the mean position at the same time but in the opposite direction, then the phase difference is phi. Now, epoch. Here, epoch means the starting phase. The starting phase of the particle is called epoch. The starting phase of the particle. Here, the starting phase of the particle means if y is equal to a sine omega t. In this, y is equal to a sine omega t. Here, this a sine omega t plus phi also we can write. Here, this phi is called epoch, that is the starting phase of the particle. And this total omega t plus phi is called phase, and this phi is called epoch, and this is called epoch. Here, amplitude means the maximum displacement of a particle from the mean position. The maximum displacement of a particle from the mean position is called amplitude. Here, this amplitude is denoted with A. Y is equal to A. This Y is equal to Y maximum, that is maximum displacement is equal to, we can get amplitude A. Now, from these equations, here where the velocity becomes maximum and where the displacement becomes maximum. Here, at extreme positions, the displacement is maximum. Then we'll get amplitude.